strengthen that life within your church, that we may know your presence, observe your commands, and proclaim the gospel to every nation. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you.
morning to everyone.
Good morning, Father Jerome.
A warm welcome to our act of worship here today. Special welcome to those worshiping with us via our Facebook page. Today we celebrate the Most Holy Trinity, and so the collects and readings are for the same. All the depth of riches and wisdom and knowledge of God, for from him and through him and to him are all things. To him be glory forever. Amen. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Alleluia, alleluia.
And blessed be his kingdom,
now and forever.
Amen.
Alleluia,
alleluia.
Blessed Lord and Father,
we have assembled in your name
and in fellowship with one another. Enable us by your grace to offer the sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, to proclaim and respond to your holy word. Teach us to pray for your brother and your church.
Grant that we, confessing our sins,
may worthily offer to you our souls and bodies as a living sacrifice. And eat and drink of your spiritual food in this holy sacrament.
Amen.
Almighty God,
to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hidden. Cleanse the thoughts of all hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Of the Lord.
written in the book of Isaiah, chapter 6, beginning at the first verse. In the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord sitting on a throne, high and lofty, and the hem of his robe filled the temple. Seraphs were in attendance above him. Each had 6 wings. With 2 they covered their faces, and with 2 they covered their feet, and with 2 they flew. And one called to another and said, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory." The pivots on the thresholds shook at the voices of those who called, and the house filled with smoke. And I said, "Woe is me, I am lost, for I am a man of unclean lips, and I live among a people of unclean lips. Yet my eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts." Then one of the seraphs flew to me, holding a live coal that had been taken from the altar with a pair of tongs. The seraph touched my mouth with it and said, "Now that this has touched your lips, your guilt has departed and your sin is blotted out." Then I heard the voice of the Lord saying, "Whom shall I send and who will go for us?" And I said, "Here I am, send me." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. brothers and sisters. We are debtors, not to the flesh, to live according to the flesh. For if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the deeds of the body, you will live. For all who are led by the Spirit of God are children of God. For you did not receive a spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you have received a spirit of adoption. When we cry, Abba, Father, it is that very Spirit bearing witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And if children, then heirs, heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ. If in fact we suffer with him, so that we may also be glorified with him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to John.
Glory to Christ, our Savior.
Now there was a Pharisee named Nicodemus, a leader of the Jews. He came to Jesus by night and said to him, "Rabbi, we know that you are a teacher who has come from God, for no one can do these things that you do apart from the presence of God." Jesus answered him, "Very truly, I tell you, no one can see the kingdom of God without being born from above." Nicodemus said to him, "How can anyone be born after having grown old? Can one enter a second time into the mother's womb and be born?" Jesus answered, "Very truly I tell you, no one can enter the kingdom of God without being born of water and spirit. What is born of the flesh is flesh, and what is born of the spirit is spirit. Do not be astonished that I said to you, you must be born from above. The wind blows where it chooses, and you hear the sound of it, but you do not know where it comes from or where it goes. So it is with everyone who is born of the Spirit." Nicodemus said to him, "How can these things be?" Jesus answered him, "Are you a teacher of Israel, and yet you do not understand these things? Very truly I tell you, we speak of what we know and testify to what we have seen, yet you do not receive our testimony. If I have told you about earthly things and you do not believe, how can you believe if I tell you about heavenly things? No one has ascended into heaven except the one who descended from heaven, the Son of Man. And just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whoever believes in him may have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but may have eternal life. Indeed, God did not send the Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved him."
This is the gospel of Christ.
Grace to
Christ. Thank you. God our Father, you see your children growing up in an unsteady and confusing world. Show them that your ways give more life than the ways of the world, and that following you is better than chasing after selfish goals. Help them to take failure not as a measure of their worth, but as a chance for a new start. Give them strength to hold their faith in you and to keep alive their joy in your creation. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. I speak to you in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen. Today is an interesting day in the life of the church. Today is Trinity Sunday. It is the day when we come face to face with what many see as the most challenging doctrine to wrap one's mind around. God is a unity of three persons, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Three in one and one in three. When one comes to church, one expects to hear an erudite exposition on ousia and hypostasis. The truth is, our human thoughts and words are incapable of grasping the greatness of God. But yet, they do help to point us to a greater reality, and that is the completeness of God. Now, the doctrine of the Trinity did not just appear out of nowhere, or out of someone's desire to sound intelligent, but rather it came out of prayer and wrestling with the experiences of the church. It was the church's many experiences and God's revelation that came before any words of doctrine. The early church took what it experienced, understood, and learnt about God, and then used the words and concepts of its time to make sense of its experiences. Unfortunately, centuries later, the words that came out of the church's experiences have become just words. They seem not to point to the reality of an experience of God, but merely to concepts that stand alone. And so speaking of the Trinity often seems to be an academic exercise of unraveling confusing terms. But as confusing as words without any context or experience may be, they do still have their purpose and can guide us to our own experience. When we speak of God as three in one and one in three, we recognize that we speak of a unity in diversity. We're speaking about the oneness and completeness of God. And we must realize that we too are a part of this oneness. Just a week ago, we celebrated Pentecost, and our focus came to the third person of the Trinity, the Holy Spirit. And part of our understanding of the day of Pentecost is that God, the Holy Spirit, is present and active in all creation. His influence is everywhere. Our understanding of God in all things and all things in God is grounded theologically in an understanding of the Spirit of God as the power of creation and the wellspring of life. It is through the Spirit of God that God participates in creation's past, present, and future. More and more, we need to come to understand this oneness with God, a oneness that we are a part of. The experiences of today, as difficult as it may be to believe, still help us to understand this oneness. And this brings me to a conversation that I had with a young Anglican a few years ago about the Trinity. And I'm going to share her testimony, in inverted commas, with you this morning. It was a testimony in which she said that as far as she was concerned, God is using simple things to reveal himself to us. If only we would open our hearts and our minds to him. She began by telling me that she was never able to understand the Trinity. Countless sermons with their big words and deep-sounding concepts were preached or were heard, and they either went over the head or they went out through the window, and they just didn't help. And this is what she said to me. I was a teenager at the time, about 15 years old. The concept of the Trinity puzzled me. I could not wrap my brain around it. Three in one, one in three. I knew it was a fundamental belief of Christianity. And so if I was to call myself a Christian, I needed to believe it. I needed to understand it. I needed to know it was possible. So I decided to pray. Day in and day out, I prayed and asked God to help me to understand. God, I want to understand the Trinity. I want to believe in you as you are. Help me to understand. And I prayed and prayed and prayed. I went to the fridge to get a drink of water. And there and then, God revealed himself to me and spoke to me. His message was clear, and in that moment, I understood. A smile came across her face, and she stopped there. So I asked, aren't you going to tell me what was revealed to you? The one earthly element we cannot live without exists like God, the one thing we cannot live without. Water exists so easily in three different forms, carrying out three distinct functions, even called three different names, but it's all water. Nothing is added to it or taken from it. I was amazed as I listened to this testimony of God's revelation of himself to a then 15-year-old child. Sorry, I should say child. 15-year-old girl. What her testimony said to me was not that I will use this example to explain the Trinity. For I'm sure some theologians and scientists alike may challenge it on some levels. But what it said to me was that we still experience God in today's world. Just like the early church used the tools of its time to put into words its experiences and understanding, so too does it happen today. So rather than trying to intellectualize God and trying to explain the mystery of the Trinity, something that we will never be able to truly do, why not pray that we experience him? Why not try, through prayer, to grow closer to God and experience his oneness? Rather than trying to live only from the experiences of others, why not pray that our eyes can be opened to how God manifests himself to us in our lives? So that we may come through our own experiences and revelations of him to a deeper understanding of him. The early church did it. This young girl did it. Why can't we? The God we serve is awesome and truly beyond our words, imagination, concepts, and explanation. But he is calling us to experience him in his unity. We can only do this if we set aside our human desire to explain everything, to have an answer for everything, and simply open ourselves to experience him. I pray that we do open ourselves to God and allow him to manifest himself, reveal himself to us. God is real and at work in this world, at work in our lives. Those who are open to experiences with him and to trusting and having faith in him are the ones who can and will truly testify to his greatness. And this testimony would be done not merely by their words, but more importantly, by the lives they live and the love they share. That is how we should all testify to the mystery of God here on earth. Amen.
Let us now, with confidence, confess our faith in our triune God. As we say in the words of the Nicene Creed, we believe in one God, Father the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen or unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, one in me with the Father, through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he was born of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered, died, and was buried. On the third day, he rose again. In fulfillment of the scriptures, he ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, giver of life, who proceeds from the Father. With the Father and Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
Let us pray. Let us pray with faith to the blessed and glorious Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Preserve your church in the true faith to acknowledge with awe and reverence the mystery of the Holy Trinity. Fill our worship with adoration. Give us due humility and assurance as members of the church which you have created, loved, and sanctified. Lord, in your mercy. Open human eyes to wonders, to the wonder of things unseen, make all lives richer in the hope of blessings more than we can comprehend. Give clearer vision to those in positions of power and influence. Lord, in your mercy. Grant to us in our own lives and share in the mutual love of the Holy Trinity. May that unbroken harmony be shown in our families, in our work, and in all our relationships. Lord, in your mercy. Have mercy on those whose lives are crippled by strain and anxiety in themselves and hostility to others. Release their tension, give them inward peace, restore them to the wholeness which is your will for all. Lord, in your mercy. We pray for the departed who in this world held fast to the faith of the Holy Trinity and now adore you forever. May their example strengthen and prepare us for the coming joy made complete and love, made perfect in your heavenly kingdom. Lord, in your mercy. May our prayers be received in the unity of the Holy Trinity, three persons in one God. Amen.
Continue in this time of prayer. I invite us all to bring to mind members of our family, our friends, our shattered members who are unwell at this time. As we see them now with our mind's eye, let us pray God's strength upon them. Pray that they feel the presence of God as they journey through challenging experiences. And they know that God is indeed always with them. Will never leave them, will never forsake them. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, graciously comfort your servants who are unwell, and bless the means made use of for their care and cure. Fill their hearts with confidence that, though at times they may be afraid, they yet may put their trust in you. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. I ask your prayers at this time for our old Sister Marty. She mourns the passing of her mother, Vinny, who passed away last night. Let's pray God's comfort and strength upon her and her family. And may they indeed be comforted with the knowledge that one whom they love to dearly is now wrapped in the arms of Almighty God. Place where there is no pain, a pure joy and love, a true oneness with God. For many we pray, rest eternal grant unto her, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon her. May her soul and the souls of the faithful depart for the mercies of God. Rest in peace. Remember our sister in our prayers. We are indeed mindful of how precious life is, precious every moment is. And so at this time, I invite us to join with our brothers and sisters who are celebrating this gift of life and celebrating their birthdays or anniversaries. And if indeed you are present here this morning and you are celebrating today during this week, or you have celebrated previously and you were not present, I invite you to come forward to the altar as we have been to each other. Let us pray. Watch over your children, O Lord, as their days increase. Bless and guide them wherever they may be. Strengthen them when they stand, comfort them when they are discouraged or sorrowful. Raise them up if they fall. And in their hearts may the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, abide with them all the days of their lives. This we ask through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
The act of penitence. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, God is faithful and just, and will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Let us therefore confess our sins. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you. Thought, word, and deed, by what we have done, and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We have not loved ourselves as we ought. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways. Glory. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness. And keep you in life eternal. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
We are the body of Christ. By the one Spirit, we are all baptized into one body and have all been made to drink of the one Spirit.
Let us then pursue things that make for peace and build up the common life.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Please be seated for our notices.
Good morning and welcome everyone.
Good morning.
Welcome to those also watching us online this morning. And I think we're all family this morning, no first-time visitors, so we can go right into our notices. And so, for those of you who were not here last week, there is a provincial mandate to engage in educational programs on baptism in preparation for the return to the practice of holy baptism being the gateway to Holy Communion. And as such, we will be hosting a baptism education program every Thursday in June at 6:30 p.m. It will be conducted by Zoom, and it will be facilitated by Canon Noel Burke, the lecturer in Baptism and Eucharist at Codrington College. So starting this Thursday, the 3rd of June at 6:30 p.m., all are invited to join the sessions as we seek to learn more together at St. George's, and Zoom details will follow. So the Mothers Union would like to thank everyone who came out to the lip sync and karaoke battle on Friday night. your participation, your creativity, your encouragement really made this a wonderful event. Yes, we appreciated every shout and hoop and whistle and cat call. Thank you so much. It couldn't have been what it was if without your participation. So today is the last day for you to hand in your envelopes with your donations towards the St. Vincent relief effort. There are still a couple of envelopes left at the back, so you can feel free to submit your donation. Midweek service this week will take place at 10 a.m. on the 3rd of June, rather than the usual 7:30. Just to note that. Yes, and changing gears a bit, many of us would have noticed increasing incidences of tragic acts of violence against particularly women carried out by their partners. And for some, this issue may hit closer to home, and we may wonder, what can we do? So we can educate ourselves and we can offer prayers and support for those people who are impacted and for the work of the agencies that provide shelter and resources for them. And so it is with this in mind that you are invited to a service of prayer and healing this Saturday, the 5th of June at 6 p.m. in support of persons affected by domestic violence. There'll be a representative from the Cayman Islands Crisis Center on hand. She will be speaking to this issue, and there will be a special collection taken up in aid of the work of the Crisis Center in these islands. So we look forward to seeing you. And last, but by no means least, the beautiful flowers in the sanctuary this morning are given by the Trickett family in loving memory of the late Michael Trickett, husband, father, and grandfather. Take note of your calendar of activities for all the things coming up in June. And unless there's anything further, I do wish you a wonderful day and a productive week.
I'm gonna see you.
Father, we offer for you these gifts which you have given us.
This bread, this wine, this money.
With them we offer ourselves, our lives, and our work, to become through your Holy Spirit a reasonable, holy, and lively sacrifice. As this bread and wine become the body and blood of Christ, so may we and all your people become channels of your love. Through the same Christ our Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father Almighty, everlasting God, for in the mystery of your Godhead, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, you have revealed your glory, three persons equal in majesty, undivided in splendor, yet one Lord, one God, ever to be worshipped and glorified. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name.
Fashioned us in your image. In your tender compassion, you sent your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior, to share our human nature. In the power of the Holy Spirit, he overcame the power of sin and death and brought your people to new birth as first fruits of your new creation. On the night that he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take this and eat it. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And after supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, Father, according to the command of your dearly beloved Son. The body and blood of your Son, Jesus, our Lord and Redeemer. As we partake of this holy food of new and unending life, may your Holy Spirit establish us as a royal priesthood with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Saint George, and all your sons and daughters who share in your eternal inheritance through Jesus Christ, our Lord. With him, and in him, and through him, by the power of the Holy Spirit, we worship you, Father Almighty, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, in songs of everlasting praise.
Thank you.
grace of God for the people of God.
Our souls will be peace and be satisfied, and we will sing that song of grace to him.
Thank you.
body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Send us now into the world of peace, and grant us the strength and courage to love and serve you, and all persons in you, with gladness and singleness of heart, through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
God, the Holy Trinity, make you strong with faith and love, defend you on every side, and guide you in truth and peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you this day and forevermore. My brothers and sisters in Christ, let us now go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen.
A blessed and joyful day and week to everyone.
Thanks and same to you.